Hello students, this is Praveen Khanna and I am back today with line graph activity. So that is academic task 1, and in this line graph, as you can see, the fuel usage is given, that is from year 1800 to year 2000, and you have been given 4 different type of fuels: wood, coal, oil and gas. And then on your y-axis you have been given percentage fuel used. Alright, so we can clearly see by the year 1800, 100% of fuel usage was of wood, and then with the passage of time this fuel usage decreased, and beyond 1950 it started decreasing, we can say slowly. And then with the start of 19th century, because now year 1800 to year 1900 is 19th century. With the start of 19th century, a new fuel, which is coal, you can say the use of coal started with the start of 19th century. So, and this fuel consumption increased, and simultaneously there was decrease in the usage of wood. And then we again see, students, by the start of 20th century, that is year 1900, so two new fuels were introduced, oil and gas. Okay, so the thing is quite simple, students. For explaining this particular task, what we will do is we will explain the trend of wood and coal in one body paragraph, and later the trend of oil and gas can be explained in another body paragraph. Or what we can do is, in this case, we can explain first century in body paragraph 1, that is from year 1800 to 1900, and then secondly years 1900 to 2000 can be explained in body paragraph 2. Okay, so before moving, let us also go through what this statement is also saying. The graph shows the percentage of 4 different types of fuels in use between years 1800 to 2000. Okay, that we have already understood. So means hardly there is then anything left. And now one thing is quite understood, that we will explain this particular task in past indefinite. Okay, so here is table which I have made. So you can use these following combinations to explain the task. The linear graph, in place of linear graph you can write line graph, or reveals, shows, infers. So it is singular, that's why we are putting s after verb. The usage, the use, the utility, the withdrawal, in percentage, in proportion, or otherwise you can say infers proportional withdrawal. Okay, of different fuels, of various combustible resources, of diverse fuel alternatives from 1800 to 2000, over the period of 2 centuries or during 200 years. So means you can use any combination to introduce your task. Now your task is understood to you, and let us start. Okay, so first of all is the introduction. So here is the introduction. The line graph infers the variation in proportional usage of 4 fuel resources over period of 2 centuries. Now we have also mentioned which 2 centuries, 19th and 20th. Okay, so this is 19th and this is 20th. Okay, so this is your introduction. Now it is very much clear that at the start wood was mainly used for all purposes, and with the passage of time the usage of wood declined, and in year 1800 a new fuel as an alternative, coal, was introduced, and with the passage of time its consumption increased. Okay, so that trend will be explained. Let us start further and write body paragraph. So this is body paragraph. It is vividly apparent that wood was solely meeting energy requirement at the start. Now at this particular point, wood was solely meeting energy requirement at the start. Then with the progress of time its utility declined, and simultaneously, now at the same time, that's why I have written simultaneously, coal was emerging as an alternative energy supplier. So coal was emerging. Okay, following this pace, almost by 1875 both fuels came at stage of equal contribution, that is 50%. Now this is somewhere here, it is 1875. Okay, by the year 1875 both fuels came at stage of equal contribution, and beyond this point by approximately 1920, by approximately 1920, coal reached its apex of delivering 67% power, whereas for wood, power supply dropped to 30%. Now over here it is somewhere 30% by year 1920. Okay, so that is first body paragraph, and in second body paragraph we will be talking about remaining time. So it was in 1900 two new substitutes of energy production were introduced, and they were oil and gas. Okay, these were oil and gas, and with new fuels mankind continued to reduce reliance from initial ones. Now when these two fuels were introduced at the very same time, the reliance from other fuels, initial fuels, started to decline. Okay, and consequently by year 1950, wood and coal were fulfilling 5% and 45% power need, and oil and gas generated 28% and 18% respectively, okay, by year 1950. Fine, and finally by the end of the 20th century, oils and gas rising trend clashed. So means these both came to the same point, with decreasing usage of coal at 33%. Now there is a clash, coal, oil and gas, that's why this clash word is used, and I'm repeating this sentence. So by the end of 20th century, oils and gas rising trend clashed with decreasing usage of coal at 33%. So from here coal was coming, and from here oil and gas were coming, so clashed at 33%, and by this time usage of wood became zero over here. So usage of wood became zero, and then finally is the conclusion. In conclusion, the graph reveals the regular replacement of oil energy resource with the new one. So regularly, initially there was wood which was replaced by coal, and then after coal there were oil and gas. So oil and gas replaced coal. So that's why this line has been written. The graph reveals the regular replacement of oil energy resource with new ones, coincidentally after attaining the zenith point or the highest point. Okay, so that is now complete task. Okay, and thanks for watching. That is the end. We will meet in next video. Bye bye. This is Praveen Khanna signing.